Hey guys, I will just share some testimonies with you. I will see if it's working, the internet, if I'm on live. I don't know how much the internet connection is, so I'll just wait a little to people are on and make sign that you are there and then you're on, and then I will say something here. So let me know if I'm on and the sound is working. So we are right now a place in near between Abu Dhabi and Dubai, and we are on a food place, and if you see behind me, it's different. There is many kind of people here, and but it's really amazing. It's really amazing. First, I want to just share some testimony what happened. We were in Dubai yesterday, and we were today in Abu Dhabi. And yesterday was really amazing also. We saw many people are open for prayer. We prayed for so many people. We had baptism in the morning. A guy who worked at a hotel, they talked with, and he got baptized. Yesterday evening we came in to people and then went in and prayed for them in the shops, and they got filled with the Holy Spirit. Yes, even this is a Muslim country, but there is so many nationalities here. There is people from all over the world. There is a lot of people from Indonesia. There is a lot of people from Africa. There is Philippines. So there is a lot of people all over. And people are very open to pray for. What have been special is we often pray for one people, and then they get healed, and then they get at the next, and they get healed and get at next. And again and again, we stood up with like 10 people just healed like this, and big group of people. And it has been good. Today we went to Abu Dhabi, and it was interesting because there was a guy who that had been prophesied over him that things should happen, and we should, and we came, and it was the way. I cannot say details without, I don't want to say too much. But we had a guy with us who have a special job, and they were prophesying over him that a man with that special job will come and step in and connect with them. And it happened today. And a lot of things happened. You can just hear one testimony short from Robert. Robert, can you just share a testimony from the beach? What happened today on the beach? With the first one?
Yeah, we met four persons from Nigeria. The first one, the last one we spoke to, and I asked him, like, do you have any pain? And he said, no, none of us, because he also asked other people. Then I asked him, like, are you Christian? He said, yes. So I said, like, have you been baptized, like water baptized? Yes. And he said, like, I think he was 19 or something when he did that. I said, did you repent before? Yes, he did. I said, but are you spirit filled? He said, no, that is the thing lacking. And I've been wondering, like, how do I get the spirit? Because I don't think I have it. And then I said, well, I can pray for you. And then I prayed for him. And then first he started to speak a little bit, and then I found out that it was just speaking English. He was praying like along with me. But then right after that, I said to him, like, the Holy Spirit will speak through you. And then I prayed for him again, and then he started to speak in tongues. And I didn't share with you before, but he was just speaking in tongues. So at one point I tapped him on the shoulder, and he did not react. He just kept on talking.
And then it came out of him like...
Yeah, it came out of him himself. And then I kind of like squeezed him in the shoulder again, like, but he was not reacting. And then again, I said like, Isaac. And then in the end, he reacted, and he said, whoa, what was this? And then I explained, and he said, wow, this is beautiful. Yeah, so it was really beautiful to see.
But try to mention this, we are talking about...
I forgot one thing, yeah, because he also said, like, this morning I felt like I had to go to the beach. But yeah, he had no, he did not exactly why. But now, obviously, after the talk, he said, like, now I understand I had to be here.
But try to mention this, here we have a guy in Abu Dhabi, He wanted the Holy Spirit, and he felt I should go to the beach today. He did not know why, and there he met Robert, and he got the Holy Spirit. The people Robert was with, see, it was amazing because it was a couple from South Africa who lived here, who have lived here 10 years in this country. They saw a video on YouTube, and then heard that we came, and they came. Today, in the beginning of the meeting, I prayed for both of them, started speaking tongues. Nobody spoke in tongues. He really got set free. We took the man out. He got kickstarted. He was totally on fire. He prayed for people. Robert took the wife out and really got kickstarted. Yeah. And she said, I have been living in this country for 10 years, but I was so filled up with fear. I did not know I could go out and do it, and now I just love it.
Because it even went further, like we stepped like 50 meters and then we met like 10 ladies. And we started to talk with them. Five of them had like issues with the health, and then this this lady who we took with, who Torben prayed for them, saw them being healed. So that was the first time she saw people being healed through her. Then some people experienced that demons were leaving them. So that was also the first time she experienced that. And then two women, we talked a very long talk, I think we talked about like over half an hour. And then two ladies said that we would like to be baptized. One received the Holy Spirit when we prayed for her right then. And then we were asking like, where are you living? And then we're only living like 2 minutes from where, from each other. So next Friday they will meet, like the 10 ladies. They will meet in her apartment, they watch the movie, and two of them get baptized, and perhaps more.
So you guys say a new fellowship started today. Yeah. and it was really beautiful. Yeah. It's good here.
Yeah, absolutely.
So it's beautiful. I can just go around and some testimonies. I also you experienced things you haven't experienced, like
yesterday.
How was that?
We went to old Dubai and one person got healed, he calls the next person. I had to pray, and then suddenly 8, 9, 10 people wanted prayer and they all got healed. It was so crazy, I never had that in my life.
So a lot of things happen, and people like I have learned here. You also got a strong spirit. You prayed for a woman who got baptized the Holy Spirit yesterday also.
Yes.
And how is it here?
Well, I was out with a little group of five, and then the wife of the organizer of this thing, she received the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And he got healed, his legs, his feet, his leg grew out. And he had got prayer because he had fear. He didn't dare speak in tongues sometimes. Another man got healed from kidney problem. Well, we hope. I mean, you don't see that right away.
But it was good.
Yeah, it was really good.
You love it here?
I like it, yes.
But as many people, you love it? And you, so everyone have their own story. Some people look a little more like the local.
Assalamu alaikum.
Is it good to be here?
Yeah, really good, really good. God is amazing.
So I want to say it has been really, really good. And I think for us again, we talk a lot about the fear. The fear that is, of course, when you are placed like here and do things, you have to be wise. You have to be led by the Spirit. I thought about it. If you take Luke 10, Jesus sent us out as lamb among wolf. He did not say, I send you out as lamb among wolf, therefore be fearful, be full of fear. He didn't say that. He said, I send you out as lamb among wolf, be wise. So we should be wise, we should not be fearful. And I see like the family we're with today, they said we have lived here 10 years, but we are full of fear and we thought we could not do that. The person, there was a boy we met today, a lot of things happened with him. We actually just ended up baptizing him. So we had a baptism just a short time ago in Abu Dhabi, just outside the mosque at the ocean with the beautiful view all over. And for me it's also, Jesus say, I send out lamb one wolves, be wise, not fearful. He did not say there is a lot of wolf here, it's dangerous here, so it's best you don't go out. No, he sent them out. Here we are a place where we of course it can cost. It can cost for local people, it can cost when we do things, people can get thrown out of the country if it is and it happens. Local people things worst thing can happen. But I want to say that it's nothing compared to the time of Jesus. If you lived at the time of Jesus, worst thing will happen. Here, if you're not local, you can lose your job, you can lose your house, you can be thrown out. If you lived at the time of Jesus, you'll be thrown for the lion. So remember the first church was a church of martyr Christianity, but it didn't stop them. Because the good news is you shall live even when you die. The good news is that they will throw you in jail, they will persecute you, they will do a lot of things. But the good news is that you have a big reward in heaven. So don't be afraid for him who can kill your body, but fear him who can let soul and body get lost. And this is the thing, we need to be wise, but we should not be afraid. And I would say this trip has been amazing. Dubai is amazing, Abu Dhabi is amazing, the Emirates here, I love this place, I love the people. So it's been really, really good. What we do tomorrow, we'll go home now. We have two long days already. So we will sleep long tomorrow, and then tomorrow we will take our desert day. We go out in the desert and we just go away from everything, away from the city, away from everything, and we'll be out in the desert and we will sleep out there tomorrow night. And then on Sunday we have got new contacts. New contacts is coming all the time. So on Sunday we will have some mini kickstart in Dubai, and then we'll go to labor camps and reach the people who are working there in different places. So we look forward to that. So God bless you all. This place is amazing. The people here is amazing. And if we talk about kickstarting people and praying for people, it's one of the most easy places I have been to pray for people. They are so open, they are so nice. You can get a little intimidated sometimes if you look at the outward appearance. But when we look at the person behind that and just go in freedom and boldness, led by the Holy Spirit, it's so easy and it's so amazing. We'll send more testimony from this place later. God bless you all out there. Thank you for your prayer. God is good. And so can we get a yeah in the end? It's good to be here.
Yeah!
Yeah! Ooh la la. Bye bye.
I'm with the friends.